Hey, yo, real talk, Six. As soon as you played me this gen, I already knew. I was like, yo, this is some fucking Last Call shit. And it got me hella excited because I always wanted to do like a Last Call. I remember the first time I heard Kanye's, I thought that shit was so tight, dog. And I was like, man, I'm trying to tell my story, you know what I'm saying? And then I remember Cole did it. What did he do? He was on Friday night. Nah, he did it on a warm-up, yo. And we did Last Call on a warm-up. I was like, damn, I'm trying to do mine. So since this joint got that vibe, I'm going to do my own Last Call right now for y'all. And my voice is messed up too. This is the last track on Young Sinatra.
Yeah, back in the day I wasn't shit, homie. Penny pits and I couldn't even pay the rent, homie. Think about it, I wonder where them years went, homie. Just a youngin' trying to survive, they was hating on me. I was working that 9 to 5, I was waiting, homie. I was busting tables, fantasizing about kicking, homie. Letting them slip away, my dreams wasn't waiting on me. This for anyone with ambition. Calling anybody that'll listen, I'm wishing all your dreams come true, cause mine did. And yeah, you know I had to put that in a rhyme, kid. But that shit came from sacrifice. Not on the corner selling drugs and smacking dice. Listen, yeah. Some way, somehow, I understood finally. If you wanna come and get it, you know where to find me. Cause I ain't got no time for anybody that be trying me. No, if they don't understand, I'ma leave them behind me. Obviously, I ain't got no time, no. I said, obviously. I don't got no time,
I treat a beat like it's my only son. My DNA, and it's that southern playalistic shit. Like we was in the A back in the day. I was young, broken, infamous. A young Sinatra that was undeniable. Who welcomed you to forever while under pressure and told you the incredible true story of Bobby Tarantino and everybody in the Ultra 85. Goddamn, it feel good to be alive. And all these bitches that I passed up couldn't fuck with you cause your hair was too gassed up. Remember creeping with the gap masked up. Goddamn, it's kinda crazy to reminisce on all this shit, man. What it was like growing up. Damn, man, just motherfuckers running in and out of the crib, doing drugs, selling drugs, all types of stuff. Meanwhile, I was just trying to keep it together. I was trying to make sense of all the shit around me. I didn't know how to take it, how to perceive it, you know what I mean? And then meanwhile, I'm supposed to be going to school and getting good grades and shit. But I'm seeing like domestic violence in my house and just so much going on, and I'm sure everybody was probably like, man, yo, why Lil Bobby didn't come to school today? On the real, I was doing anything to run away, and that's the same reason kids join gangs every day, cause they wanna be accepted, but at home they too neglected. Meanwhile, white America quick to call him a thug, but all he ever wanted was a father to give him some love, tell him that he love him, that he need him, promise he won't never leave him, never smoke crack, never lie, and won't never beat him. It feel like for my life I've been needed to break. Looking at my family, I ain't wanna make the same mistake. And I know that shit sound fucked up, but they not all doing great. Oh God, please, can I have a conversation with a member of my family without it ending asking me for 5 G's to pay their bills or their lawyer fees? Huh, I learned something, I ain't giving y'all a dime. I'll give you something worth more, that's my time. I ain't dropping stacks, I'm dropping knowledge. Unless it's for my nieces and nephews to go to college. And hit me on the phone, hit me up like Uncle Bob, where you at? Yeah, I know your pocket's fat, but I don't give a fuck about that. I'm glad we family. We a half-breed family. Man, see, I remember when I was like 15 years old and my dad took me to the studio. I know this is random, but I'm trying to take you guys through it, right? And I'll never forget, I had like 8 rhyme books. He'll tell you, man. I went through the motherfuckers. I was rapping for like 15 minutes straight. And that was my first time, yo. I was like 10th grade in a studio, and I knew that this is what I wanted to do. I knew it ever since I first saw Kill Bill. I've been flowing like that blood Uma Thurman spilled. None other than the RZA, yeah, he did the soundtrack. And then I discovered Wu-Tang soon as I found that. And then Big Elmo's Def and Nas, it with no turning back. I couldn't change it if I tried, homie, how about that? See, I'm a student of the game, so simple and plain. But I'ma take it back to before I ever sat first class on a plane. I was in College Park, right? Well, I guess technically if you wanna go before that, I was living in Germantown. Or no, actually it was Montgomery Village. Back in Maryland, I was living in my sister's basement. And then some shit happened, you know, she kicked me out. It was Christmas, whatever, I love you, Jeannie. Anyway, so shit happened, and then I just kept it pushing. You know, I was homeless for a little while, whatever. You know, I stayed at my mentor's house, Solomon. And then I stayed back at my godparents' house. Mary Jo and Bernie, I love y'all. Mary Jo, I'm sorry, back when I used to smoke, I would steal the shit out of your cigarettes. I love you, I'm sorry about that. But you remember, always she would let me record. I'd always be recording in an attic or wherever I could. So I love you, thank you for supporting me there. But then she was like, you gotta get the fuck out of here too. After a while, she gave me some time.
But like, I was 20 years old at this point. She was like, nah, you gotta get the fuck out of here and do something with your life. And this was right around the time that I opened up my first show ever for Ghostface Killer, man, in Gaithersburg, right in Old Town. The shit was insane, I'll never forget it. And that's where I met my boy Lenny, Big Lembo, what's up? That's right, man, we just started kicking it and hanging. He lived in College Park, and before I knew it, I was living with him in his basement. And this is right around the time I met Six. And Six was going to the University of Maryland at the time, which was right down the street. So I'd always go to their dorm room. I remember there were nights I would just crash in the dorm room. We was making beats. We was doing all types of shit, man. When we first got out, we did the first Young Sinatra. And now we on the fourth Young Sinatra, motherfucker. That shit is crazy, man. And I remember, like, I used to steal quarters from Lenny just so I could go to the 7-Eleven and eat. And he was like, you idiot, why you stealing? Just ask me, bro. And I was supposed to get a job. I was sleeping in his basement on the couch, which is the cover to my first album, Under Pressure. Shout out Kathy, shout out the Rasalem family, all my beautiful brown people. We made it, that's crazy. But nah, listen, I'm getting ahead of myself. So like, I was staying with him and I was supposed to get a job, right? And he was like, yo, you gotta get a fucking job, bro. Things were going so good with the music that we kind of stopped talking about it. It seemed like every week something new was happening, and I just sat him down one day and I was like, look, bro, can you just give me 1 year? Like, just give me 1 year, man. Let me put everything into this, and if I don't get it, fuck it. I'll just submit, and I'll just blend into society. And he was like, bro, I'm gonna give you 1 year. And for 1 year, him, his family, all the homies, Benny, everybody, man, they took care of me. He put clothes on my back. He put food in my stomach. You know, he helped me with microphones and recording. And yo, almost a year to the fucking day, bro, I signed a Def Jam. And my man, he was a land surveyor out there, like, making sure all the buildings get built. Rain, snow, sleet, all that shit for 12 years, dog. And when I signed my deal, I said, fuck that, quit your job, we're moving to LA. This shit was crazy. So we get to LA, we're staying off Coldwater Canyon, Alta Mesa, in Studio City, man. And I'm going to the studio with no ID every day, and like, shit is crazy. That's the first time I met Cole. Yo, shout out Cole, that's my fucking boy. Big Sean, all these homies, man, that I met, it was crazy. Don Cannon, everybody. That's when I first met Kev, Bobby, my engineer. What up, Bobby? It was just like, life was insane. I dropped Young Sinatra, Undeniable, and that was crazy. That was insane, cause that was the first time me and my boys ever hit the road. On the real, you know, we went from zero to overload. Performing in front of the fans, had their hands waving. This is all I ever wanted, this is all I'm craving. Me and my boy Chris shot the game. Two visionaries on the mission, shit ain't been the same. Some ups and downs came around, had a lot of problems. But no matter what happened, you know we'd always solve them. Yeah, we'd always solve them. Like, man, it's kind of crazy thinking about it, though. Like, so much has happened, yo. And I mean, by the time y'all are hearing this, I'm 28, I'm 27 while I'm recording it. I mean, right now, literally, I'm working on Bobby Tarantino, Ultra 85, Young Sinatra 4, and a whole bunch of other shit, man. This is crazy. Acting, writing, like, I'm just so, I can't believe I'm here, man. We grinded for so long, we worked for so long, yo. And motherfuckers, they hate you, man. They try to make me feel bad about how I look, how I speak, how I rap, how I act. My race, my everything. They fucking hate you, man. They'll hate you when you're in this position. But you can't let them. You can't let them, let that shit get to you, man. Continue to persevere. Continue to be the best you can be. Cause I'm here right now, man. Best friends. I got everything I could ever want, man. Even though you always want more deep down and you got goals deep down, that's great, man. But fuck that shit. I'm so happy. I'm so blessed, man. So if you're listening to this right now, no matter how old you are, how young you are, whether you're on a school bus, headed to get your education, or you driving home from work pissed off at your boss, just, man, just please do what you love in life. So many people, they always say, oh, you know, I would do this, but, or I can't because, and you already fucking lost. They lost. And I feel bad for that person because that person won't never make it. I would, but I don't have the money. I would, but I don't have the time. Fuck that. You gotta do it, man. You gotta do what makes you happy. You have to live selfishly in that aspect. Stop worrying about others. Stop freaking out. Just focus on yourself, man, and your own happiness. That's the realest thing. And that's all I can tell you, because you can't help anybody else until you can help yourself. You know what I'm saying? So please, put the mask on first, like they say on the airplane. Cause put your own motherfucking mask on and go do it, man. Go do it. Just live your life. I love y'all. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed this Young Sinatra experience. I know I have. This is probably going to be the last one, though. It's going to be the last one for sure. I'm coming back with some fun, but don't know. I love you guys. Ultra 85 is gonna be crazy. I mean crazy. Bobby Tarantino's that trap shit. Woo! We took him back with just boom bap. Now we finna head to the future. We ain't scared. We making music for everybody, you know what I mean? I love y'all. Look at that Merlin accent coming out. I don't know why. Every time I get on the mic, that Merlin accent. Go ahead, could y'all like all day. Boy, you sound like Wale, back of your neck. I love y'all so much. Rat Pack. Yeah.